This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Desktop Window Manager DWM, previously Desktop Compositing Engine or DCE, is the window manager in Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8 and Windows 10 that enables the use of hardware acceleration to render the graphical user interface of Windows. It was originally created to enable portions of the new Windows Aero user experience, which allowed for effects such as transparency, 3D window switching and more. It is also included with Windows Server 2008, but requires the desktop experience feature and compatible graphics drivers to be installed. Contents: 1. Architecture, 2. Redirection, 3. Hardware requirements, 4. See also 5. References, 6. External links. Architecture: The Desktop Window Manager is a compositing window manager. This means that each program has a buffer that it writes data to. DWM then composites each program's buffer into a final image by comparison. The Stacking Window Manager in Windows XP and earlier, and also Windows Vista and Windows 7 with Windows Aero disabled, comprises a single display buffer to which all programs write. DWM works in different ways depending on the operating system, Windows 7 or Windows Vista, and on the version of the graphics drivers it uses. WDDM 10 or 11 under Windows 7 and with WDDM 11 drivers, DWM only writes the program's buffer to the video RAM, even if it is a graphics device interface GDI program. This is because Windows 7 supports limited hardware acceleration for GDI, and in doing so does not need to keep a copy of the buffer in system RAM so that the CPU can write to it, because the compositor has access to the graphics of all applications. It easily allows visual effects that string together visuals from multiple applications, such as transparency. DWM uses DirectX 9 to perform the function of compositing and rendering in the GPU, freeing the CPU of the task of managing the rendering from the off-screen buffers to the display. However, it does not affect applications painting to the off-screen buffers. Depending on the technologies used for that, this might still be CPU-bound. DWM agnostic rendering techniques like GDI are redirected to the buffers by rendering the user interface UI as bitmaps. DWM aware rendering technologies like WPF directly make the internal data structures available in a DWM-compatible format. The window contents in the buffers are then converted to DirectX textures. The desktop itself is a full-screen direct 3D surface, with windows being represented as a mesh consisting of two adjacent and mutually inverted triangles, which are transformed to represent a 2D rectangle. The texture, representing the UI chrome, is then mapped onto these rectangles. Window transitions are implemented as transformations of the meshes, using shader programs with Windows Vista. The transitions are limited to the set of built-in shaders that implement the transformations. Greg Schechter, a developer at Microsoft, has suggested that this might be opened up for developers and users to plug in their own effects in a future release. DWM only maps the primary desktop object as a 3D surface. Other desktop objects, including virtual desktops as well as the secure desktop used by user account control, are not. Windows Flip 3D demonstrates multiple features of DWM: 3D transformation of 2D planes, scaling and translating the planes to a different position, embedding dynamic views of one application in another, and use of custom shader programs. Windows Flip 3D feature being used in Windows 7. The blur effect of Windows Aero, which blurs the background when viewing through the window borders, is enabled by the DWM Compositing Manager, using custom pixel shader programs. Because all applications render to an off-screen buffer, they can be read off the buffer embedded in other applications as well. Since the off-screen buffer is constantly updated by the application, the embedded rendering will be a dynamic representation of the application window, and not a static rendering. This is how the live thumbnail previews and Windows Flip work in Windows Vista and Windows 7. DWM exposes a public API that allows applications to access these thumbnail representations. The size of the thumbnail is not fixed. Applications can request the thumbnails at any size, smaller than the original window, at the same size, or even larger, and DWM will scale them properly before returning. Windows Flip 3D does not use the public thumbnail APIs, as they do not allow for directly accessing using the Direct 3D textures instead. Flip 3D is implemented directly in the DWM engine. The Desktop Window Manager uses Media Integration Layer MIL, the unmanaged compositor which it shares with Windows Presentation Foundation, to represent the windows as composition nodes in a composition tree. The composition tree represents the desktop and all the windows hosted in it, which are then rendered by MIL from the back of the scene to the front. Since all the windows contribute to the final image, the color of a resultant pixel can be decided by more than one window. This is used to implement effects such as per pixel transparency. DWM allows custom shaders to be invoked to control how pixels from multiple applications are used to create the displayed pixel. The DWM includes built-in Pixel Shader 20 programs which compute the color of a pixel in a window by averaging the color of the pixel as determined by the window behind it and its neighboring pixels. These shaders are used by DWM to achieve the blur effect in the window borders of windows managed by DWM, and optionally for the areas where it is requested by the application. Since MIL provides a retained mode graphics system by caching the composition trees, the job of repainting and refreshing the screen when windows are moved is handled by DWM and MIL, freeing the application of the responsibility. The background data is already in the composition tree and the off-screen buffers and is directly used to render the background in pre-Vista Windows OS's. Background applications had to be requested to re-render themselves by sending them the WM_paint message. DWM uses double buffered graphics to prevent flickering and tearing when moving windows. The compositing engine uses optimizations such as culling to improve performance, as well as not redrawing areas that have not changed because the compositor is multi-monitor aware. DWM natively supports this too during full screen applications, such as games. DWM does not perform window compositing and therefore performance will not appreciably decrease on Windows 8 and Windows Server 2012. DWM is used at all times and cannot be disabled, due to the new start screen experience implemented. Since the DWM process is usually required to run at all times on Windows 8, users experiencing an issue with the process are seeing memory usage decrease after a system reboot. This is often the first step in a long list of troubleshooting tasks that can help. It is possible to prevent DWM from restarting temporarily in Windows 8, which causes the desktop to turn black, the taskbar gray, and break the start screen. Modern apps, but desktop apps will continue to function and appear just like Windows 7 and Vista's basic theme, based on the single buffer renderer used by XP. They also use Windows 8's a centered title bar, visible within Windows pre-installation environment. Starting up Windows without DWM will not work because the lock screen requires DWM, so it can only be done on the fly, and does not have any practical purposes. Starting with Windows 10, disabling DWM in such a way will cause the entire compositing engine to break, even traditional desktop apps, due to universal app implementations in the taskbar and new start menu. Unlike its predecessors, Windows 8 supports basic display adapters through Windows Advanced Rasterization Platform Warp, which uses software rendering and the CPU to render the interface rather than the graphics card. This allows DWM to function without compatible drivers, but not at the same level of performance as with a normal graphics card. DWM on Windows 8 also adds support for stereoscopic 3D redirection for rendering techniques that are not DWM aware. Output must be redirected to the DWM buffers with Windows. Either GDI or DirectX can be used for rendering to make these two work with DWM. Redirection techniques for both are provided with GDI, which is the most used UI rendering technique in Microsoft Windows. Each application window is notified when it or a part of it comes in view, and it is the job of the application to render itself without DWM. The rendering rasterizes the UI in a buffer in video memory, from where it is rendered to the screen under DWM. GDI calls are redirected to use the canonical display driver CDDDLL, a software renderer. A buffer equal to the size of the window is allocated in system memory and CDDDLL outputs to this buffer rather than the video memory. Another buffer is allocated in the video memory to represent the DirectX surface, which is used as the texture for the window meshes. The system memory buffer is converted to the DirectX surface separately, and kept in sync. This roundabout route is required because GDI cannot output directly in DirectX pixel format. The surface is read by the compositor and is composited to the desktop in video memory. Writing the output of GDI to system memory is not hardware accelerated, nor is conversion to the DirectX surface when a GDI window is minimized, invisible or visible on the same monitor as a full-screen DirectX application. application. By limitation of GDI, the GDI bitmap buffer is no longer received by the application when requesting a device context during painting or updating. This can sometimes be seen when a GDI operation copying from one window to another outputs black or empty regions instead of the expected window content. Thus, DWM uses the last bitmap rendered to the buffer before the application was minimized starting from Windows 7. Canonical display driver no longer renders to the system memory copy when a WDDM11, DXGI11 compliant video driver is present. For applications using DirectX to write to a 3D surface, the DirectX implementation in Windows Vista uses WDDM to share the surface with DWM. DWM then uses the surface directly and maps it into the window meshes for Windows Presentation Foundation WPF applications, which are DirectX applications. The compositor renders to such shared surfaces, which are then composited into the final desktop applications. Can mix either rendering technique across multiple child windows, as long as both GDI and DirectX are not used to render the same window. In that case, the ordering between DirectX and GDI rendering cannot be guaranteed, and as such it cannot be guaranteed that the GDI bitmap from the system memory has been translated to the video memory surface. This means that the final composition may not contain the GDI rendered elements. To prevent this, DWM is temporarily turned off, as long as an application which mixes GDI and DirectX in the same window is running hardware requirements. In Windows Vista, DWM requires compatible physical or virtual hardware, a GPU that supports the Windows display driver model WDDM Direct 3D 9 support pixel shader 20 support for 32 bits per pixel passes the Windows Aero acceptance test in the Windows driver kit WDK. In Windows 7, the desktop window manager has been reworked to use Direct 3D 101, but the hardware requirements remain the same as in Windows Vista. Direct 3D 9 hardware is supported with the 10 level 9 layer introduced in the Direct 3D 11 runtime. Windows 8 has the same requirements as 7, but it can also use software rendering when compatible video hardware is absent. Hardware virtualization software that emulate hardware required for DWM include VirtualBox 41 and later, VMware Fusion 30 and later, and VMware Workstation 70 onwards. In addition, Windows Virtual PC allows composition using the remote desktop protocol. See also Compiz References. How to enable Windows Vista user experience features on a computer that is running Windows Server 2008 MSKB947036. Knowledge Base Microsoft January 15, 2008. Retrieved 21 April 2008. 14 October 2007. Caret System Requirements for Windows Vista. Microsoft 13 November 2007. Retrieved 11 February 2009. Disk Defragmenter Driver Verifier Event Viewer iExpress Management Console NetSH Recovery Console Resource Monitor Scan Disk Settings App SysPrep System Configuration System File Checker System Information System Policy Editor System Restore Task Manager Windows Error Reporting Windows Installer PowerShell Windows Update Windows Insider WinRewmi Apps Calculator Calendar Character Map Cortana DVD Player Edge Fax and Scan Groove Magnifier Mail Maps MSN Apps News, Weather, Sports, Money Movie Maker Movies Sticky Notes Store Wallet Windows To Go WordPad Xbox Shell Action Center Aero Autoplay Autorun ClearType Explorer Search Indexing Service iFilter Saved Search Namespace Special Folder Start Menu Taskbar Task View Windows XP Visual Styles Services Service Control Manager Bits CLFS Multimedia Class Scheduler Shadow Copy Task Scheduler Error Reporting Wireless Zero Configuration File Systems CDFS DFS XFAT IFS FAT NTFS Hard Link Junction Point Mount Point Reparse Point Symbolic Link TXFEFS Refs UDF WinFS Server Domains Active Directory DNS Group Policy Roaming User Profiles Folder Redirection Distributed Transaction Coordinator MSMQ Windows Media Services Rights Management Services IIS Remote Desktop Services WSUS SharePoint Network Access Protection PWS DFS Replication Remote Differential Compression Print Services for Unix Remote Installation Services Windows Deployment Services System Resource Manager Hyper-V Server Core Architecture Architecture of Windows NT Startup Process CSRSS Desktop Window Manager Portable Executable XDLL Enhanced Write Filter Graphics Device Interface HALDL I/O Request Packet Imaging Format Kernel Transaction Manager Library Files Logical Disk Manager LSASS MinWin NTLDR NTOSKernLex Object Manager OpenXML Paper Specification Registry Resource Protection Security Account Manager Server Message Block Shadow Copy SMSS System Idle Process User WHEA Win32 Console Win Login Security Security and Maintenance BitLocker Data Execution Prevention Family Safety Kernel Patch Protection Mandatory Integrity Control Protected Media Path User Account Control User Interface Privilege Isolation Windows Defender Windows Firewall Compatibility COMMANDCOM Virtual DOS Machine Windows on Windows WoW 64 Windows Subsystem for Linux API Active Scripting WSH VB Script J Script COM ActiveX ActiveX Document COM Structured Storage DCOM OL Automation Transaction Server Direct X Net Framework Windows Holographic Windows Runtime Universal Windows Platform Discontinued. Games 3D Pinball Chess Titans FreeCell Hearts Hover. Inkball Hold'em Mahjong Titans Minesweeper Purple Place Reversi Solitaire Spider Solitaire Tinker Apps ActiveMovie Anytime Upgrade. Address Book Backup and Restore Cardfile Cardspace Contacts Desktop Gadgets Diagnostics DriveSpace DVD Maker Fax File Manager Food Media Center Media Player Meeting Space Messaging Messenger Mobile Device Center NetMeeting NT Backup Outlook Express Travel Photo Gallery Program Manager Windows Easy Transfer WinHelp Write Others File Protection Media Control Interface Next Generation Secure Computing Base POSIX Subsystem Interix Video for Windows Windows Sideshow Windows Services for Unix Windows System Assessment Tool VE Microsoft APIs and Frameworks Graphics Desktop Window Manager Direct 2D Direct 3D D3D Extensions GDI, GDI WPF Silverlight WINRT XAML Windows Color System Windows Image Acquisition Windows Imaging Component DirectX Graphics Infrastructure DXGI Windows Advanced Rasterization Platform Wing Audio Direct Music Direct Sound DirectX Plugin XACT Speech API Saudio 2 Multimedia DirectX Media Objects Video Acceleration XInput DirectInput DirectShow Image Mastering API Managed DirectX Media Foundation XNA Windows Media Video for Windows Web MS HTML RSS Platform J Script VB Script BHO XDR Sidebar Gadgets TypeScript Data Access Components MDAC ADU ADONET ODBC OLDB Extensible Storage Engine Entity Framework Sync Framework Jet Engine MSXML OPC Networking Winsock LSP Winsock Kernel Filtering Platform NDIS Windows Rally Bits P2P API MSMQ MSMPI DirectPlay Communication Messaging API Telephony API WCF Administration and Management Win32 Console Windows Script Host WMI Extensions PowerShell Task Scheduler Offline Files Shadow Copy Windows Installer Error Reporting Event Log Common Log File System Component Model COM ActiveX Distributed Component Object Model Net Framework Libraries Framework Class Library Microsoft Foundation Classes MFC Active Template Library ATL Windows Template Library WTL Device Drivers WDM WDF KMDF UMDF WDDM NDIS UAABDAV XD Security Crypto API CAPI COM Windows Cardspace Data Protection API Security Support Provider Interface SSPI Net ASPNet ADONET Remoting Silverlight TPL WCF WCS WPF WF Software Factories EFX Factory Enterprise Library Composite UICCF CSF IPC MSRPC Dynamic Data Exchange DDE Remoting WCF Accessibility Active Accessibility UI Automation Text and Multilingual Support DirectWrite Text Services Framework Text Object Model Input Method Editor Language Interface Pack Multilingual User Interface Uniscribe